Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Evra. Student, we are learning final year subject, that is nothing but the solar and wind energy. From that subject, we have learned so many topics from unit number 1 to unit number 4. And that all points are related to the solar energy. Now, in the today's lecture, we are going to see some points related to the unit number 5, that is wind energy. Related to unit number 5 also, we have seen some videos. So, those who don't have seen that videos, you can see that video. And in the today's lecture, we are going to see the new concept or the case study related to the wind energy or wind power plant. So, one case study we have to see, that is nothing but estimation of required wind turbine power rating. That means what? We have to calculate or estimate the required wind turbine power rating. That means what? For developing the required amount of power, that is electrical or mechanical power, how much amount or how much rating of power rating wind mill is required, that we have to estimate. Okay, so that is nothing but the estimation of required wind turbine power. Okay, so let's see, if we want to design or if we want to achieve the required amount of power, there should be the two factors which will affect that requirements. First one is the availability of the winds. That means what? The wind should be not in the fluctuating rate. So if we require the too much higher power and wind is at the low speed, we are not able to develop that much of the power. So as per our requirement, there will be the input of the wind flow. That is the first factor which will affect the requirement of our electrical power or mechanical power. Okay, so let's see how to estimate the wind turbine rating required for the wind turbine that we are going to see. So for that, we have to assume some asset. So let's see which are the assumptions we have to make. So assume that the annual energy requirement of an industry is a 20,000 kilowatt hour. That means what? The annual energy requirement of an industry is a 20,000 kilowatt hour. That means what? For running the particular types of the industry, for annual purpose, that industry required 20,000 kilowatt hour of the power. And that power is nothing but the electrical power. Now, we are going to develop that 20,000 kilowatt hour power from the wind energy. All of you understand that? So that is the case study, that we have to develop the 20,000 kilowatt hour power for the operation, annual operation of that particular industry. Now we have to consider, or we have to find out that how much rating wind mill is required to develop that much of the power. So what should be the size of wind turbine that is required to be installed to meet the energy requirement? That means what? For the required amount of the annual power, 20,000 kilowatt hour, how much power rating wind turbine is required, that we have to find out. All of you understand that? That is nothing but the case study, today's case study, estimation of required wind turbine power rating. So following are the assumptions are taken into the accounts for the estimation. That means for calculating the power rating, we should assume some concept. So let's see which assumptions we have to make. So annual energy requirement that we have seen, that is nothing but 20,000 kilowatt hour. Okay, then propeller type wind machine is used. That means the blades are of the size propeller type. So propeller type wind machine are used. Then coefficient of performance. That is the important factor which we have to assume. So generally the coefficient of performance varies from 0.30 to 0.50 for the wind mill. But here we are going to consider coefficient of performance is a 0.40. On an average, we are going to consider 0.40. That means 40% coefficient of performance is there. So we have considered 0.40. Now, wind speed. That is an important concept which we have to assess. So, wind speed at 50 meter height is 5 meter per second. What we have taken? We have taken the height of windmill is 50 meters. And at that height, the wind speed we have considered, that is nothing but 5 meter per second. Wind speed we have considered 5 meter per second. If the turbine hub is placed at the height other than the 15 meters, the wind speed should be estimated as shown in vertical wind speed variation section. That means that section we have seen in the previous video. So those who have don't seen that video, you can see that video, so you will understand. So from that table we have taken, for 15 meter height of the wind turbine or hub, we have considered the wind speed 5 meter per second. Then we have to consider density of the air. So density of the air, all of you know, density of the air 1 kg per meter cube. Density of water also we have seen, 1000 kg per meter cube. Then capacity factor. So capacity factor we have considered 0.30. That is 30% of the time wind machine is producing the energy at rated power. That means capacity factor means what? For how much time period that windmill is producing the rated power. That is nothing but the capacity factor. And capacity factor we have considered as a 0.30. That is 30%. Now, number of hours in a year. That means in the year, for how many hours that windmill is working. So on an average we have considered 8760 hours per annual working of that windmill is there. All of you understand that? So that's are the assumptions which we have considered for estimating the windmill power rating. So step by step we are going to calculate the power rating of that windmill. So how many steps they have given? Total 3 steps are there by which we can calculate the power rating of the windmill. So let's see step by step all the conditions. So step number 1 is related to find out the power density of wind. Power density of wind means what? The power per unit area. That means per unit area, how much power that windmill is generating, that we have to calculate. So power density of the air, that is the ideal. So power density of air we are going to calculate. The turbine hub at 15 meter height is considered. So we have considered the height of the windmill, that is the hub, is a 15 meters. And at that we have considered the wind speed 5 meter per second. So we are going to calculate power density of the air. So power density of the air is nothing but 1/2 into air density into the velocity. Density we are going to calculate, so air density into the velocity. So density of the air is 1. So 1 by 2 means 0.5. density of air we know 1 into velocity of the air. So at 15 meter height of the hub, we have considered the velocity 5 meter per second. So velocity is nothing but the 5. So 5 cube we have to take. So the power density we have got, that is nothing but 62.5 watt per meter square. It is a power density. That's why the unit is watt per meter square. So we have got the power density 62.5 watt per meter square. So that is the first stage, that we have find out the power density. Now let's see the second stage. So second stage is related to the find out useful power and energy density. In the first stage we have calculated power density. Now in the second stage we have to calculate the useful power out of that total power, and the energy density we have to consider. Consider the losses, actual power density that will be converted to useful energy. So how to calculate the useful power or energy density? That is nothing but CP, that is the specific heat, that is coefficient of performance. So CP into transmission loss into generator loss. So in the windmill, as we have seen, the losses in the windmills or in the solar panel, So the two types of losses are there in the windmill: transmission loss and generator loss. So CPE is nothing but coefficient of performance, that we have taken 0.40. Transmission loss we are going to consider 0.90% transmission loss, and generator loss we are going to also consider 90%, so 0.90. Then overall loss factor we can calculate, CP into transmission loss into generator loss. So overall loss factor becomes 0.324. okay, so overall loss factor is equals to ideal power density into overall loss factor. All of you understand? So actual power density is nothing but 62.5 into 0.324, and actual power density is nothing but 20.25 watt per meter square. Now we are going to see annual energy density. So annual energy density we will calculate by the formula power density into number of hours per year. So power density into number of hours per year. So power density is nothing but 20.25 into number of hours per year are 8760. So it becomes 177.39 kilowatt hour per meter square. So that is nothing but the annual energy density, that is the useful power, and it becomes 177.39 kilowatt per meter square, kilowatt hour per meter square. The real annual energy density will be less as the wind of the rated speed will not blow for the 8760 hours. That means the speed of the wind will be vary. So thus, considering the capacity factor, the real annual energy density is equals to annual energy density useful into the capacity factor. So annual useful energy we have calculated 177.39 into capacity factor we have taken 30%, so 0.30. so the real annual energy density we have got 53.2 kilowatt hour per meter square. Now in the step number 3, we are going to find out the rotor size and the turbine power rating. So the area of the turbine can be estimated from the real energy density. So area of rotor is equals to total annual energy required upon real annual energy density. So total annual energy required is 20,000 kilowatt hour, and real annual energy density we have got 53.2 kilowatt hour per meter square. So the area of the rotors become 375.8 meters square. That means it is near around 380 meters square. Okay, so radius of rotor we can calculate. Radius is equals to pi r square, area is equals to pi r square. So area we have calculated 370.58. Now pi r square, so r we have got 10.9 meter. So radius of the rotor blade we have got 10.9 meter. That means near around 11 meters. Now last step, we can estimate the actual power rating of the turbine. So it is obtained by multiplying the actual power density with the area of the rotor. So power rating of the turbine is equals to actual power density into the area of the rotor. So actual power density is nothing but 20.25 into area of the rotor we have taken 375.8. So the power rating of the turbine is nothing but 7.6 kilowatt hour, and that is near around 8 kilowatt hours. All of you understand how we have calculated the power rating of the turbine? That is, we have got the 7.6, that means near around 8 kilowatt hours of the wind turbine we have to use to generate the 20,000 kilowatt hour of the energy annually for the required industries. The cost of the wind turbine on per kilowatt hour basis runs between 30,000 and rupees 50,000. That means the cost of setting the wind turbine is between 30,000 to 50,000. So for above calculation, an 8 kilowatt hour wind turbine would cost 8 into 40,000, we will take on an average, it becomes 33,20,000. That means what? for the required amount of the electrical power annually for the particular industry, that is 20,000 kilowatt of power, 8 kilowatt of the power rating windmill we have to install, and the installation charges for that 8 kilowatt of the power rating of wind turbine, that is nothing but the 320,000. So like that, in the today's lecture we have seen how to estimate the wind turbine power rating for the required amount of electrical power generation, and also along with that we have calculated the estimation of cost of the installation of wind energy of required power rating also. So I think all of you have understand how to estimate or how to calculate the power rating of the wind turbine for required amount of electrical energy. So student, we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next lecture.